गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर ऑफ कंप्यूटर फंडामेंटल्स. लास्ट वीक आई हैड गिवन यू द नोट्स रिलेटेड टू कंप्यूटर फंडामेंटल्स. कंप्यूटर इज एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस विच कैन अप्लाई सर्टन लॉजिकल सीरीज टू प्रोसेस सर्टन ऑपरेशंस. इट कैन एक्सेप्ट डेटा, सेव डेटा एंड प्रोसेस लॉट्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन एज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट एंड द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर. सो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर गिवन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक इज कंप्यूटर इज एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस विच कैन एक्सेप्ट डेटा, अप्लाई अ सीरीज ऑफ लॉजिकल प्रोसेस टू इट एंड सप्लाई द रिजल्ट्स टू दीज प्रोसेसेस एज एन इंफॉर्मेशन. So this is the first part of computers. Computers has history of various generation, 1G, 2G, 3G, 4G, and these generations are responsible for production of various kinds of central processing units and the monitors and the keyboards in the various generation of computers. Now we will study two main types of a computer, that is an analog computer and a digital computer. Now analog computer, why is analog computer used? Where is analog computer used? It's used as a counter in certain of your instruments. What is the work of an analog computer? In analog computer, you can measure magnitudes like voltage, mechanical moments, and in digital computer, you can transfer any data into binary notation and save it. In this chapter, we will be mainly focusing on digital part of the computer, or you can say digital computers. A computer system in general has how many parts? You all know it. So the parts which they have with them is central processing unit, the most important part of the computer, CPU, then the monitor, then there are certain external parts of our computer, that is keyboard, mouse, joystick, sometimes speaker, sometimes it can have internet card, internet or LAN connection cable. These are the external parts of your computer. Also, in olden computers, means those computers who were from 1G or 2G, G means generation, they had, or 3G, they had, don't mix this with the telecommunication 1G, 2G and 3G, they won't have same relevance because both the technologies are different. One is a storage device, one is a communication system. So here I would like to tell you all that is, what were the parts of your CPU from the first computer till date? The parts inside the CPU were the memories. With memories, there were certain processors and certain control units. So what happens with the processor or what happens with the CPU that we are now going to consider? Here, secondary or auxiliary storage is meant for data flow and control signal, as I told you now. After this, we will discuss about the block diagram of computer. Further to that, we have other parts of the computer. So whatever communication interface a computer can do, means a computer can send email from one computer to other computer or to other LAN. In this condition, there is internet card. These days, your processor has internet card inbuilt. In prior days, that is in 1999 or 2000, just 20 years ago, we had to interface a different internet card. Then, if you wanted to listen to music on the with the help of CPU, you had to arrange a different speaker. These days, in CPU, you might have to arrange a speaker, but in a laptop, there is an inbuilt speaker. So this is the difference between the technology. Then comes about the video card. Audio couldn't be displayed directly. So we required a sound card. For video card, we have image interface as well as an audio card together to create a video card. And there were various other secondary devices used for computer to become a better device to store data and as well as make it bring it to a use of an entertainment device. Now we will come to block diagram of computer. A digital computer is a multi-purpose programmable machine that can read binary instructions from its memory, accept binary data as input, and process data according to those instructions and provides results as a output. So this is the basic definition of digital computer. All these questions, do they look silly for you, have a weightage of 3-4 marks in your paper, in your electronics 2 paper. So for today, please prepare this nicely such that you can perform better. Then comes, how is your computer being divided into, or which are the types of parts which are available inside your computer? Inside your computer, two types of parts are available, hardware and software. So what does hardware contain? A physical component which you can physically hold in your hand and experience are called as hardware components. What are the types of hardware components? You have monitor, then you have other parts, that is the mouse, the keyboard, then you have a hard disk which is inside the CPU, then there is motherboard. Motherboard is the place where all the parts of the processing unit of your computer are present. What are these parts? Memories, types of address buses, logic units, certain semiconductor devices which are required for processing the information in your phone. Sorry, not in your phone. Nowadays, your phone has also become a computer. In your CPU. Then, what is a software? Software is a set of instructions for a computer to perform a certain task. Now, suppose you want to write a program in C++ or in C. You require Turbo C in your mobile or in your computer or in your laptop. Then what happens with the software? Once the software is been installed in your memory, the required program which you want to run in that particular software can run. Suppose you want to crop a photo. Now these days, cropping photo or making video audio is also possible on mobile because of the best quality processor. Now what is this processor? Processor is ideally a semiconductor chip. This semiconductor chip is required to process the data coming to your digital device. Digital device can be computer, laptop, or your mobile phone. So, what exactly happens inside the CPU, or we will also discuss about the block diagram of a computer. Now in the block diagram of the computer, you will see that there is an arrow connected from input to control unit and from control unit to output. So first you have to give the input data. So how is this input data added to your computer? The input data could be added by mouse, through clicks and through selections, through keyboard by using various keys, through speaker. Through microphone by speaking something, by joystick which is used to play a game. Nowadays it is rarely used. You can use directly the mouse, or there are different types of joysticks which are meant to play only certain games. Then there are various other kinds of input devices like your scanner, optical scanner. Then there are magnetic ink character recognition. This is used in commercial shops, or you can say in stores like DMart. Then you have light pen, which was prior used to see the data on the screen or to read the data on the screen. And here there are, then these days you have a USB connector also. You can connect 4-5 USB together through this USB connector. And these are various types of input devices which you can use in your day-to-day life as an input device. Now we will talk about the central processing unit. What happens in the central processing unit? The central processing unit is the brain of your computer. It temporarily stores data and instructions for performing certain kinds of operations on your CPU. Then comes the next thing. A computer consists of input device, central processing unit, and an output device, and a second and an auxiliary storage. And now what is there inside central processing unit? Inside central processing unit, you have control unit, arithmetic logic unit, primary memory, and secondary memory. Now what happens in arithmetic and logic unit? Here you can perform all the mathematical operations. There could be 8-bit, 16-bit, 32-bit operations which can be performed in arithmetic logic unit. Then comes the next part, that is the control unit. This part eliminates the human need, the need of the human operator. Here this unit is synchronous with time. The time which is set on your CPU helps this unit to perform operations. Means it helps just to give the data that a particular operation is performed in how many seconds, minutes, and hours. Then we come to the next part, that is the primary memory. Primary memory is the basic memory of your computer which is required to be used for performing certain types of calculations and operations. Then these memories are of various types. One memory is of magnetic core kind of memory, and another memory is semiconductor or the cache memory. The types of semiconductor memories which you will study further are RAM, ROM, EPROM. Then we have PROM and EEPROM. So RAM is random access memory, ROM is read-only memory, then is programmable read-only memory, that is PROM. EPROM is erasable programmable read-only memory, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory is EEPROM. Okay, and magnetic core memories were present in first and second generation of your computer. Then we will come back to the types of output devices. Now what are these output devices? They give output to us. This converts the data into a final result with the help of central processing unit and a control unit and various other parts of the computer. The first thing is, what is the output device? So machine to man means we all cannot read all the binary codes. Suppose I type hello Madura through keyboard, you see it on the monitor. How is the data being processed? If I write hello Madura, my keyboard will give the ASCII code, which is in binary form, to the CPU. The CPU will accept that data. Then till the time the data is not stored, the data bus, which is used to transfer set of binary numbers together or set of address which is given by binary numbers together or binary combinations together, is being
given to your monitor. The monitor converts the binary, the CPU helps the monitor to convert the data into human interface, like how a human being can read. I cannot read the ASCII code of Hello Madura. I have to read Hello Madura only after typing hello, the word Hello Madura. So the ASCII code is again converted back into the respective symbols, and then I can read the word Hello Madura. Then in the further part, what happens with us is, which are the various types of output devices: printers, plotters, magnetic disc, magnetic tapes. And there is one more output device which we will study later in this chapter, that is computer output microfilm. Then secondary hard disks, which are not installed inside your computer but are externally used. Then we can also use, save the output in floppy disks, compact disks, and in your favorite pen drive. Then comes the secondary auxiliary memory. Now, what happens with secondary auxiliary memory? It is not so expensive to buy, is the first thing. It increases the storage capacity. It has magnetic disks and magnetic tapes. You are born in the generation of semiconductor memories. So I hardly know someone, or hardly somebody might be having those audio cassettes at home. Those are the basics of the magnetic tapes, which we are using in our day-to-day, which we were using in our childhood, in our day-to-day life to listen to songs. Even today, companies like MTNL store the call record, that is the traffic and the tariff record, on the magnetic tapes. Those reels on which the films were wound, the sides of those reels were used to store the data. You could use one reel for storing data of 90 days. It depends, of course, upon the length. The blocks at the side of the reels were used to save information. The films which were recorded in olden days were also stored on those films, on those, around those blocks. The mid part just is the supporting part. All have seen negative of a photograph. Check with your parents if they have negative of any photograph these days with them. If they have a negative of this photograph, they will definitely tell you the importance of this negative. This negative was used prior to develop a positive. This negative was used in front of a projector to project a photo. After projecting the photo, it was put into certain chemical reaction in the chemical lab, and these photos of 4 by 6 inches, 5 by 8 inches was being produced. Or you can say 5 by 7 inches, 6 by 8 inches means the resolution has to be constant, 4:3 or 16:9. These all parameters you will see in the editors of your mobile phone. So this is how the secondary storage world worked. Steve Jobs had said a statement some 30 years ago that 640 KB memory is sufficient for a person to store his lifetime data. And today 640 KB is just like nothing for you all when you use social media apps like WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram on your phone. Because of the availability of the camera, an input device to the computer, has increased your limitation of the app data. And because of which more and more information could be stored in your phone, just in a size of 4 inches by 3 inches. So this is how things have started working with you all. Do you all know how to calculate the size of the screen? The size of the screen. When somebody says this is a 29-inch TV, or somebody says it is a 42-inch TV. How is this size brought into picture? We have to check the length and the breadth of the screen, or the height of the screen. Put those values in Pythagoras theorem. You will get a diagonal value. So length square plus breadth square is equal to diagonal square. Take under root of diagonal square. You will get the value of a diagonal. So if the value of the diagonal is 29 inches, then the diagonal length of the screen of your TV is 29 inches. This is how the screen size is being calculated. This is an extra input given from my side to you all. Now we will discuss about the control lines and the data flow lines which are shown in the block diagram. Then here we will come to know that the primary or each of the peripheral is been assigned a binary number with which it can be identified. This is called address. Suppose I stay in Srinath apartment 4. So what is my address inside the apartment? That will be displayed outside my apartment. So that address will tell you that you have to come to so and so home in my apartment. Then comes the binary number 4 with 4 bits, 8 bits, 16 or more bits. In general, if R is the base of this number, which is chosen as 2, and N are the number of address lines, then the memory location is denoted by M. Now, we are using various kinds of communication apps. How are they encrypted? Anybody knows the concept of encryption? Suppose my name is Madhura. You have kept me a pet name. For example, Don. For example, I don't know how many of them say this. Then, if you call me Don, in front of me, I will never understand. This is converting the word Madhura to Don is called as encryption. Means you are coding the information. This process is called as ciphering, in which you will convert the information from normal human interface information to machine interface. You can create that code and you can chat also with your friends. But I'm just giving you all an example. Then comes the next part. That is, how will you do deciphering? Conversion of encrypted information into normal interface information at the receiver end is called as deciphering. You know why the Zoom app was being hacked? While using Zoom app, you will see that there is a personal ID code available at the top. This personal ID code is being used for what? To encrypt your communication. Means nobody else can tap and get into your communication. This encryption technology now in various phones is between 128 bits to 256 bits. Probably will be converted to 512 bits and later it will be converted to 1024 bits. So why is this all these things are done for your own betterment and for the betterment of the human being. Otherwise information can get hacked. This can affect the national data, the national information center, the defense system of the nation, and everything can get ruined. This is how we are going to conclude our today's lecture. Today's homework is write the answer of log diagram two times of computer. In the next lecture, that is on next Saturday, I will teach concept of bus, input device, output device and memories. Later, in the next half of the May month, I will teach you all electronics one. So if you all have any doubts and queries, contact me through comments or through WhatsApp. Thank you.